What's going on, NBL Network? We are live, building the franchise, Washington football team, episode number one, week three action, 2-0 with our Washington boys taking on the 0-2 Denver Broncos in the Mile High Stadium. Should be a good one. Get sound in the game going. Let's get it rocking and rolling here early. Let me know how it looks and sounds in the chat. You're going to notice our main man, Bananas. Right? He's going to be over here somewhere. It's coming up soon. There it is right there. There it is right there. He's straight from 1981. He was balling in 81. He had a pocket on his button up that he kept his Virginia Slims in. He looks like a cameraman, right? From like the 80s. Here we go, Denver Broncos, 0-2. Washington, 2-0. Nice user there by Bananas. Just a bad throw there. Dan Barber. He usually cuts the defense up, but hopefully not today. Appreciate everybody checking us out already. Thanks for watching Building the Franchise. Washington football team. Rolls right off the tongue. We got a couple new things. We're also going to be doing a live call. Live call at the end of the game. Oh, excuse me, let me fix that. We're going to be doing a live call with the owner of the Washington Ball Club here for the NBL. It's going to be at the end of the game. If we get the dub, we'll bring on the cameraman for the Utah Jazz in 1987. Bananas was a journeyman cameraman. Did a couple development league sports, Canadian Football League. Finally found his niche there in Salt Lake City. And he was the head cameraman there. He did the baseline cam, the baseline bums there for Utah Jazz, Salt Lake City. Kind of a known legend there around those parts.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
Pistol formation. The Denver Broncos and Tout are moving right now. Run here to this left side. It's blown up. You're going to notice with this Washington team, there is no Chase Young. Montez Sweat, number 90. He's right on the screen right there. He's going to be looking to do some damage today. As right there, you see a tackle for loss. Don't miss any of the full immersion content here on the NBL Network. Commissioner Corner Podcast will be returning soon here in NBL Season 50. You can also check out the Timeout Podcast with SERP. Should have a new episode out early this season as well. Building the Franchise, you're watching it now for Season 50. Follow a new team every season in the NBL. When in doubt, in route. 47's not having it. Dan the Barber.
Incomplete.
Can't pick up the third down. It's punt unit time. Punt, 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 punt unit. If you're interested in joining the NBL, go to 365.MaddenBomberLeague.com. And he lets that one bounce. Maybe a mistake. And we're going to get to see Lamar Jackson on the screen right now. Oh, baby, we got to hit the primetime music. Let's go. Transition. Hit it. Lamar Jackson. His debut game. Number 8, the great. We've seen it. We've witnessed it. And now it's time for us to visualize the greatness. He must be great. He must be great. But they gave up a lot for him. They gave up the whole team. Look, he's on the cover of the thumbnail. Tuesday, 1 p.m. We're watching it live. Episode 1. That's Lamar Action Jackson, number 8. Love to see him in them Washington unis. No Chase Young, no problem. We got the GUIs in the backfield with Lamar Jackson. Everything is cool, calm, and collective. He's looking like a cucumber out there.
Jackson's pass.
Cool.
Complete to Steven Sims. A gain of 9 yards.
What's going on, Rust the Buster? Appreciate everybody in the chat. Sutton. Here we go. Pistol formation for Lamar Jackson. You got guys in the backfield. Little option play, hands it off to the GUIs. Oh, looked like a face mask there. I like that play. You have to respect Lamar Jackson when you got LJ sitting right here. You got a tight end here, a fullback here, and then you got guys back here. And you run this little read option, get some blocking downfield. These ends, Simmons, Von Miller, they have to respect Lamar Jackson's speed and ability. That's going to open a hole up for Darius Geis. Here goes Lamar Jackson rolling to the outside, finds his man on the run. Lamar Jackson, 2 of 2, 23 yards. And just like that, they're at the 38-yard line. Logan Thomas, first reception of the day for him. The Washington Redskins come into this game at 2-0. Player to watch today out of Ohio State, third-round pick, Thomas Hall. 6'1", 260 pounds. 21-year-old rookie playing defensive end, hopefully to replace or at least try to fill the shoes as Lamar Jackson. And you don't say that very much. He goes down outside of the pocket, chased down by 57. Got to watch the left end, Thomas Hall. He's the one that's going to be playing alongside Montez Sweat. So while you lose Chase Young, you lose a first-round pick, you bring in Lamar Jackson, you're pairing him with Scary Terry, Darius Geis, Logan Thomas, Steven Sims. That's a skill position player. Oh, almost sacked again. Dangerous throw picked off. Oh, it was supposed to be. Oh, my gosh. Bananas, I got to do it to you.
This guy's got to be blind to throw that interception. He's terrible.
Intercepted.
Wow.
The Broncos take over.
Boye, former Jacksonville Jaguar, number 21, getting his primetime action on. A little primetime INT here for Denver. Over the middle. Give me that right back. 2-6 with the sticks. Oh, he's to the end zone. That's going to be a touchdown. I'm calling it now. Too easy.
Put those
touchdown, Washington.
Because that's a touchdown, baby.
Oh, man. If you're the Washington football team, you got to be wondering. Are we a little concerned about Lamar Jackson here? 36 viewers watching. Appreciate you guys checking out Building the Franchise. Episode number one. Lamar Jackson, one possession, two throws. A completion to Logan Thomas, followed up by an INT to A.J. Boye. But Denver gave it right back on the ensuing possession. Nice lurk underneath by Bananas. Gets that pick six, puts points on the board. But, yeah, we haven't seen much of Lamar Jackson early on. But so far this season, he hasn't had those impressive numbers. As far as passing the ball, they rank 32nd in the NBL right now, only 142 passing yards a game. It's got to go up. And off Philip Lindsay, that's my fantasy football halfback. I got to see him going. 3 carries, 6 yards. Got to do better than that.
On the stop. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
Thanks for watching Building the Franchise here on the MBL Network. You can follow us on Twitter at Bomberleague at MBL Network for upcoming streams. Yeah, Spongy says that's a little touch pass over the middle. Yeah, this tight end on a little post. If he touches that, I mean, it's a cover zero hero. You got a chance. Dangerous pass right there, rolling to the left side. Dan the Barber taking a little bit of a cut there. Third and inches. As Noah Fant able to hang on to that one. Now it's a really third and manageable. Watch this. Only 5 in the box. 4 down linemen. You can run on this fairly easy, and he does. Philip Lindsay, all kinds of space, getting outside. He's got the speed for days. That's why he's my fantasy football superstar halfback. 3 carries, 6 yards. Now 4 carries, 33 yards, and that's just in a day's work for number
30.
Brad says he hates to throw out a sack. Wow, that's like one of the best additions in the game. Risky, yet rewarding at times. Makes you really question. Almost picked again. You got to stay away from this. Is that Landon Collins once again in the middle of the field? So here's what you got. Any routes in this area, if I'm Dan, the man, if I'm DB, not Dark Brawler, Dan Barber, I'm not looking here. My eyes are going here. My eyes are going here. I'm looking flats, corners, outs. I'm playing the sidelines because the middle of the field's been locked up. There he goes, crossing route. When in doubt, finds his man, number 14, Dan Barber. 46 yards and a pick for the rookie as Cortland Sutton picks up his first catch of the day, and they're inside the red zone.
At the 18-yard line.
Don't forget, don't miss any of the upcoming action. NBL Live will return. Broadcast number 353 will be coming up next here in NBL Season 50. Expect Nick Mazesco to start with some NBL Live action here early. Get our juices flowing. There goes Phillip. Lindsay takes a big hit from Troy Apke. But he holds on to the ball.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
Dan Barber's not looking bad. Not looking bad, Nemo. Two tight ends set. Two wide receivers On the left, Hannah, Phillip Lindsay, a little counter. Get into the end zone. That's fantasy football points for me. I need it. Let's go.
Because that's a touchdown, baby.
As you see, Bananas right there in the bottom right. We're going to, for those just joining us now, we're going to show you a little bit of the pick is up good, 7-7. There he is right here. Oh, we'll miss him. We're going to catch him back. You guys got to look down here. He was the cameraman in Salt Lake City for the Utah Jazz from 1987 to 1994. He has some commemorative Karl Malone and John Stockton pieces hanging at his house right now. One of his favorite Utah Jazz players of all time. You guys ready for this? Jeff Malone. He was a shooting guard during his era there as the baseline cameraman for the Utah Jazz in Salt Lake City. He had the do. He had the crew. And this guy was big money, you know, behind the lens. And now he's playing, owning a team in the NBL. Pistol formation for Lamar Jackson. Already interception on the day for him. Touch pass. Scary Terry. Not that scary there. 41 gets it done. LJ, 3-for-4, 23 yards. A lot of underneath stuff. And an INT when he tried to drive the ball down the field.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Greg Ostertag was way later. He was there when Mark Eaton was there. They say Bananas and Mark Eaton. He used to stay out there. 15. Terry gives up on the play, but they don't need him. Touchdown. Big time play. And that's how you do it.
Because that's a touchdown, baby.
Wow. I'm telling you, if you're the Washington football team right now, you'll see Lamar Jackson getting his foot loose on. Getting outside, making those type of throws that only Lamar Jackson can make. And it puts 7 on the board. They're back on top. We're back on top. We're feeling good. Early in the day, building the franchise, episode number 1, NBL season 50. Salute to the Admiral David Robinson, but this is our year here in Washington. We're 2-0, trying to go 3-0. Broncos, sorry for you. You're looking like you're going 0-3 tonight. How did Washington get Lamar? They traded Chase Young, first round pick. In the upcoming, this NBL season 51 rookie draft. And there's another piece. Someone put it in the chat right now. One of the mods or NBL owners put in the chat what the trade was for Lamar Jackson. There's my NBL fantasy football halfback, Phillip Lindsay. My team's looking pretty good. I got Dalvin Cook with Porter's Vikings. Phillip Lindsay here with the Broncos, who's just, you know, Dan the man. Dan the barber's going to rely on this guy to make some big-time plays, and he's going to do it. He did it for me last year. And then I have Irv Smith Jr., tight end from the Vikings. He's the up-and-coming tight end. He's the next Bucky Hodges there for Porter. And who's my last player? Oh, I just picked somebody off waiver wire. Terrible throw by Todd. He's truly trying to go 0-3 right there. Lay it out to play it out. 22, but tell us that's going to be an INT, and Lamar Jackson right back on the field. This is episode 1 here, building the franchise Washington football team. We'll probably do 4-6 episodes this season. And we're just trying to keep the streak alive right here. Hand off to G.U. Weiss. That's the guys. He's outside 50, 45, 40. Finds his way down to the 36-yard line. As Washington has an injury there on the line, 73. We're going to take a look and see if that how long he's going to be out. High formation here for Lamar Jackson. Yeah, Shakirs, I hope you're having a good afternoon as well. Playmaker, once again, finds his man. Geist takes a hit, holds on to the ball. Wow. Big time play for Lamar Jackson. Geist. One thing I'm noticing so far with Lamar is he really likes to bounce outside to the left. So if I'm Tout, I'm going to start looking at plays that can kind of contain off this DN spot or maybe even a corner blitz. Because you're seeing a lot of rolling out to the left side and then playmakering upfield. Lamar Jackson using his legs and making plays, and that's what he does. That's what makes him this unique, dynamic force at the quarterback position.
At the 5-yard line, a pickup of 2 brings up second and goal.
Jamie in the chat says, "Guys catches a lot for Bananas Washington team here." I just can't get over that picture down there. I just have to comment on it. And I'll tell you what, the guy to the left of him looks exactly like like T-Jax, kind of, right? A little bit? No? Oh, toss it outside. We're just getting silly with him right now. Let's go.
Put Because that's a touchdown, baby.
That's so nice. We got to play it twice.
Because that's a touchdown, baby.
Dustin Hopkins on.
What a great option there. That was a triple option. So he has the read option coming. He holds on to it. Stays out with Lamar. He's got his man rolling with him. It looks like the receiver, I mean, just kind of got ahead of him. But Lamar does a great job with the pace, keeping that pitch, that option open even deep into the play, and he ends up using it for a touchdown there, washing up 21-7.
Made at the 25-yard line. The Broncos take over.
And Game Master says the no-look pitch right there. Absolutely.
25-yard line.
If you're interested in joining the NBL, go to 365.MadamBarmerLeague.com. If you're interested in getting back up after you get hit like that, go ahead and call Phillip Lindsay because he'll tell you how. Montez Sweat taking a knee right there. Looks like he's out of breath. Maybe a little gassed. Hopefully nothing too serious, because without Montez Sweat, they lose a lot on that pass rush since they traded Chase Young to the Baltimore Ravens and their future. Phillip, wrong way. Wrong way, buddy. We're going this way. Phillip, we're going this direction. Phillip Lindsay, starts going east and west, and then he starts going south. Unless there's a scenic route or some kind of warp where you can get back to the other direction. Phillip Lindsay a little confused. Dazed and confused there as Landon Collins has been all over the field. 26 already has a lurk INT. Now a tackle for loss. You've seen him play a lot in the middle of the field there. Watch why. Doesn't go to him. Down he goes. That's what we like to call the heaters. Moreland, let's go. All right, big third and 21. And yeah, he was just gassed. Muscle cramps for Montez Sweat will return soon. There we go. Shotgun formation. Verticals. Looking at A. Takes him over the middle. Holds on to it. No, he does not. He drops the ball. Punt unit time. This is too easy for the Washington football. This is going to be a blowout, and we love it. Everyone continues to DM me, who is that guy in the bottom right? He looks familiar. Well, if you watched Utah Jazz basketball from 1987 to 1994, you are well aware of the cameraman on the baseline. He's kind of a local legend there in Salt Lake City.
34-yard line.
Yeah, tight end O.J. Howard, who they traded for in NBL season 49 with our Washington team, as well as linebacker Reuben Foster. And Howard did not have a good NBL season 49. They expected a lot more for him after they made a big trade, giving up a first-round pick to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So Foster and Howard are out today, unavailable due to injury. So maybe that's affecting Lamar Jackson's ability to really drive the ball down the field from inside the pocket. Because that was the thing coming into there. They felt like he could be a pocket quarterback as well. But right now, he's just having to improvise, get outside. And it's working out well. We're up 21-7. Yeah, you got Thurl Bailey with the – he had the James Worthy goggles on. Jeff Malone at shooting guard. Obviously, John and Carl and Big Mark Eaton. Who was a career block leader when he retired in the NBA. He is a big 7 foot forever big man, and he moved around like
Jackson's pass complete to T. Higgins.
Like Bradwood.
It's a gain of 15.
And does.
But it's third down.
Virginia Beach. JP says it keeps cutting off because I'm driving. Sorry about that. There goes man coverage. Can Lamar pick it up? Look, he's got the man on the left. Doesn't take him. Goes back to the dig. And this is what I like to see. This is a new and improved Lamar Jackson. He's got this drag coming across the field. It's open. This picks up the first down. Usually this is read number one for him. He always has been looking underneath, then deep down the field when he was with the Ravens. Now you see this deep dig. This is where he's looking. He's progressing downfield right there. Just a little too quick outside the pocket. A little instant. Kind of instinctual rollout for Lamar Jackson. He's going to have to throw the ball away, but I like what I see from Lamar so far, stepping up and looking to drive the ball down the field. We're going to have the owner of the Washington team here in the NBL. He's going to be joining us later. Oh, excuse me, wrong promo. Down he goes. Lamar Jackson sacked again. Rankins! Third and 13, big third down coming up. Yeah, we'll have a live call on air at the end of this game. And we'll be talking Utah Jazz basketball, Salt Lake City.
Third and 13.
Just a little bit. We'll be talking those Karl Malone elbows. Yeah, he was. They considered him one of their own. They consider him pretty much part of the team. I mean, that's an INT. Bad pass by Lamar Jackson. Number two on the day. Do we got something to be worried about here? I want to know in the chat. Should we be worried or no?
Throw that interception. He's terrible.
Oh, there goes his glasses. Man, this guy's. Let's watch
that
again. Watch his glasses.
To throw that interception. He's terrible.
Only bananas. Wildcat formation. Please keep it. Please keep it 30 and make a play for me. There he goes. There he goes. Lindsey's quick. Lamar Jackson is still just some passing issues we're seeing early on. He came into this game, four touchdowns, two interceptions. He had two interceptions week two against Tampa Bay in a 16-9 where he didn't play particularly well. QBR was just 7. Gonna go X, too much time. TMT, that's what happens when you don't have Chase Young. Touchdown, just like that. They're in it to win it. Touchdown. For the Denver Broncos, they cut this down to 7.
That's a touchdown, baby.
Yeah, no Chase Young, no pressure, no problem. Dan the man, Dan the barber, cutting up Washington's defense. If you can't get home to the quarterback and you let him sit in the pocket, I mean, that was just way too much time. He's just sitting here. He was really looking over on this side deep down the field. This crosser came late. You just got to wonder, I mean, how many times can you say during a game that you're going to have this much time to let this little delayed crosser come across the field in tight quarters? I mean, they're at the 30-yard line. Lamar Jackson, handoff. The read option, hands it off to Darius Geis. 5 carries, 46 yards for him. He's looked good.
That's the end of the first half with this Washington.
No, Sweat's already back.
Broncos 14. Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
Darko's saying BTF Broncos. No, absolutely not. Check the thumbnail. This is building the franchise Washington football team. Lamar Jackson, number 8. Already got 2 picks on the day. Gotta clean some of that up. Still early in the season, sitting at 2-0. Broncos looking for their first win here at home in the Mile High. Yeah, it was muscle spasms. Salt Lake City, I'm privileged to be doing this, building the franchise with this team, with this owner. Due to his work that he did with the Utah Jazz, he just really exemplified, you know, this creative Darius cameraman that you see today. You know, guys getting all the angles, getting low, getting high. One knee, two knees.
It's a gain of 10.
On the side. Taking those hits. Big Shaq running at you. That all started with our man Bananas there. Oh, nice little dead leg there by Geis, but that leg came a little too alive too quick as he lost a little bit of control. 2nd and 9 for Washington.
Tackle made at the 36-yard line. A gain of 1 yard. Brings up 2nd and 9.
Don't miss any of the upcoming action here on the NBL Network. Podcasts, NBL drafts, NBL live super shows, 2 games on the screen at one time. All kinds of great things here. If you want to join the NBL 365.MattaBomberLeague.com, that's another pick, but he can't get his feet in bounds. His banana clicked on and brought his man back. Nice job. Lamphis says, Bananas will figure it out. He's got to clean it up. You're on the road right now. You can't be making throws like that. That's just a miscommunication. You got a receiver running down this sideline. Lamar feels like he has a step. The receiver doesn't. He just dies on the play, and that almost results in an INT. Shotgun formation. Rough start. Oh, he's got a man over there. Can he get down on the seam? Can't get there. Oh, man, you got to catch that ball and get down. He's got a man running the seam, and it's naked. And Lamar Jackson, just a little hesitation. That allows this weak side safety to make his way over here and impact that pass at the probably, you know, 2-3 yards from the ball, actually hitting the receiver's hands. You start hearing those footsteps, and that safety's coming quick and in a hurry.
At their own 24-yard line.
Yeah, seam was open, Brad, and if anybody can recognize an open seam quick, it's going to be Brad. Come on, let's go. What's going on, Draco? When in doubt, angle route. Phillip Lindsay, high usage. He doesn't take the hit from Apke or Landon Collins. 30 is his number because he's trying to play till 30. He's still quick and in a hurry all the time, but he's a high usage halfback here with the Denver Broncos, and he's on my fantasy football team, and I feel like McDonald's right now because I'm loving it. Another first down. Apke lays the lumber again, but it's not enough. Let's go. Let's hit the music. Washington needs to get a stop. First and 10. You're not getting much pressure. He struggles against the run. Shout out to Sponge. He made that astute. Perceptive comment early. He said, you can't stop the run, and these three-man fronts aren't going to do it. Oh, there's the user. That actually might do it. Big time hit. Yeah, three-man front. You run a little halfback smash, and Bananas does a great job. He's got these guys engaging. One, two, three. And he's sitting here just kind of playing it out. What is this other linebacker going to do? I'm going to play off of him, and I'm going to shoot this gap and get into the backfield untouched. Shotgun formation. Melvin Gordon in the backfield. That's a handoff nowhere really to go. That's disappointing for Denver. It looked like they were on a roll like butter. He was taken down, but unable to keep the chains moving, and they're going to go for a field goal here. It's going to be a 58-yard. Let's see if we can get this in.
A 58-yard attempt.
Does it have enough leg? It does! Mile high! Home field cooking, 21-17, as the Washington was in complete control. And the Broncos were down 21-7. A little quick 10-0 run here for Denver, trying to get some momentum here in the second half. Yeah, JB, a lot of people, I'm getting a lot of DMs about it. I'm going to say this one more time for those checking in. This guy right here, he was the cameraman for the Utah Jazz, Salt Lake City. He lived up the high life, 1987 to 1994. His favorite player, Jeff Maloney, enjoyed hanging out with Mark Eaton, Thurl Bailey. The entire Utah Jazz roster knew this guy because he got all the angles. He had the one knee, the two knee, the crouch, the stand straight up, the slouch. And then obviously he had, you know, on the shoulder, on the other shoulder, just really made these guys in Utah larger than life. Lamar Jackson, ducks under, getting killed. Give me that. That's one to the house. You're not catching him. 15-10-5, and that's what Lamar Jackson does. That's why he's on the cover, and that's why he's the man here on Building the Franchise.
Put those sixes up, because that's a touchdown, baby.
Dustin Hopkins on for the extra point. The kick is good.
Yeah, that did a little dead leg.
Makes this Washington,
man, it's just so deadly. You get Lamar Jackson outside, 17. And he's able just to – you got so many quarterbacks that can move, so many mobile quarterbacks in the NBL. But this one right here, I mean, you got him kind of dead to rights, you think. And he just kind of squares you up. Maybe it's just a little shift inside, and then he breaks it right back outside. And at this point, you're just trying to figure out what the heck just happened, and he's off to the races. Denver had to settle for three on their last drive. I wish they probably could have got to 21 here and scored a touchdown. It looked promising, but a 58-yard field goal nonetheless. Throwing it away, that could have been a little dangerous. 7 of 14, the Barbers at 50% right now. So it's a 50-50 chance. You get a nice fade, or he's going to chop you up. What's up, Cougs? Hello, you cool cats and kittens. Check the bottom right of the screen. You're going to see my main man, Bananas. And you're going to see 55 right in front of your face, Dan. Oh, my gosh, that's terrible.
This guy's got to be blind to throw that interception. He's terrible.
He drops back. I don't know where he's staring, but maybe he just can't see what's in front of him. All he saw was number 14 coming across the field, but he didn't see 55. The rubber tree plant. He didn't move since the ball was hiked. He stayed there the entire time, and yet you found a way to hit him right in the numbers. See if Lamar can make another play. Already two interceptions on the day for him. Ooh, kind of lost control of that one. Throw on the run, dangerous. You notice Lamar, when he's dropping back, he's looking at Terry McLaurin. McLaurin, because Scary Terry is the one playmaker they still have on this team. O.J. Howard obviously out. Logan Thomas stepping up here, number 82, moving to that tight end one position. But O.J. Howard, they gave a first-round pick for him. And right on cue, O.J. Howard gets up and gets down. Lamar Jackson, 8 of 15, touchdown, two picks.
First and goal.
It's all about Lamar Jackson this season, NBL season 50. So we got to follow along, number 8, the great, as he progresses in this new system, new team, new me. And we already seen his explosive ability on the ground. We've seen him pitch a touchdown. Just got to clean up these turnovers. Here comes the heaters. Lamar just can't get rid of the ball. Down he goes. But they hold him to 3 here. It's a 14-point game, and we still got a quarter and a minute left. Von Miller says, yeah, that's what we're going to do.
It's second down and goal.
It's Washington's Super Bowl team. It's still early in the season, Cougs. You know, it's still too early to tell. I'll tell you what, his buddies, Carl Malone, Jeff Malone, John Stockton, they probably would definitely think he's got a chance to make it back to the Super Bowl. It's been quite a while for Bananas. Man in motion. Lamar Jackson looking. Right side. Nice check to the flat. Logan Thomas back-to-back receptions down to the 3-yard line.
Jackson's pass complete.
Yep,
to
Howard's
Thomas
out today. Brad had the injury report in the chat earlier. Don't miss any of our content. You can find us on Twitter at Bomber League, at NBL Network. Also on YouTube, youtube.com/MaddenBomberLeague. Here on Twitch for live game action, building the franchise, and NBL Live and bonus coverage. Watch guys in the backfield here, third and goal. Maybe they're going to trust number 8 to make a play. They are. Put the game out of reach. Can he do it? He's trying to put the – oh, he's got it in the wheels. Oh, he could have just ran it in. Bananas! Salt Lake City! Is crying.
Incomplete.
Why?
Fourth.
Why?
Goal.
Oh my gosh!
Line.
You know they. You know what they used to call Bananas when he was the cameraman for the Utah Jazz, 1994 all the way back to 1987. They used to call him Chuck. I don't know why. He just looks like his name could be Chuck in that picture. Here it goes. They're going for it on fourth and goal. Rolling to the left side. Nowhere to go. They're in trouble. Back shoulder. That's an INT. And that's going to put it at the 20. He did at least thrown it away. Made him start at the 3. Bananas. Could have done a little better. I don't know.
Jackson's pass intercepted. The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Oh, there's Phillip Lindsay. Fantasy Apke's going to catch him. He's so fast. 30 versus 30. Almost a 60-yard gain for Phillip Lindsay. Baby, 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 rocking and rolling. Let's get it going. Appreciate everybody checking us out, but it's primetime action now. Fourth quarter. Let's get it going.
At
the end of this game, we're going to have a live caller on air. It's going to be the owner of the Washington football team. Bananas, a.k.a. Chuck the cameraman. Well, they actually called him Chuck because Carl Malone gave him that nickname. There's another lurk pick over the middle. Gotta stop doing that. I said don't throw here. Don't throw here because you got 2-6, and he's like American Express. He's accepted everywhere. Touchdown, Washington. Easy peasy. Give me that.
Put those sixes up because that's a touchdown, baby.
Extra point is up and good, so what could have been a comeback ends up not being a comeback because of his masterful camera work and his ability to find all the angles at that baseline cameraman position. He's sitting down squatted. He's crouching. He's on his side, left side, right side. Carl Malone said, man, that's ground Chuck right there. That's my man Chuck. He's always on the ground finding a perfect angle for the most,
Phillip Lindsay,
for the highest entertainment value for those fans in Utah.
Ioannidis. It's a loss of a yard.
Now, what is Tal doing? He's thrown three picks today, and they've all been inside the hash. See, my boy Lindsay's going to get a little bit more here. Nowhere to run. 14 carries, buck 13. I'm happy with it. How many points? How many fantasy points I got? Almost 20.
A loss of two on the play.
Oh, that doesn't even include what he's got in the receiving game. Phillip Lindsay might have the highest usage rate in the NBL right now. What do you guys think? Anybody higher than him? What comes to your, what comes up in your head first when you think of usage rate in the NBL? To the right side, nice pitch and catch. Dan Barber. The old Demaryius Thomas number. Woods, two catches, 36 yards. DB 12 in the backfield. Nice throw by Dan. Finds another receiver open. Plethora of Washington defenders in the vicinity, but unable. I mean, when you're dropping in a bucket like that, you got one, you got two, you got three, and you got four, and you got a man just coming right into the soft spot of the zone, and he drops it in the bucket for a completion, but maybe too little too late. Play action. And down he goes. Montez Sweat. He's right on time, and he's timeless. Number 90 is in airplane mode right now. You can't hear him coming, but you feel it at the impact. Oh, left side. Oh, no, that's going to be a touchdown. Oh, get into the end zone. Come on, Tal. App King gets beat. Oh, wait, that's the wrong one.
Put those sixes up, because that's a touchdown, baby.
Brandon McManus lining up for the extra point. The kick is good. Makes this Washington 35, Broncos 24.
Nice pass by the barber. He calls that pass the high top fade. Just a little fade route from the 90s. And there's our man, Ground
Washington
Chuck.
Takes over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Need a big turnover. Cam's right. Down 11. 343. We're up 11. 343. Us viewers are watching a game. 11-point differential. 343. Fourth quarter. First and 10. Lamar Jackson. The GU Ice. Darius Geis. He's had some phenomenal yards and big games in the NBL. He's going for that dead leg again. That's just right stick down. I like how Bananas is using it, but he needs a downshift a little bit. He's running turbo, and then he's going right into the dead leg. If he cuts the turbo about right here and just kind of gets a little hezzy action, it's an opportunity to square up that defender and make him start chopping those feet. You can catch him on his heels and maybe bounce that outside. Single back formation, two tight ends, two wide receivers, halfback in the backfield, man. Coverage, holding coming up. Lamar Jackson, oh, he's so quick, too quick. It ain't fair, he don't care. Down to the 35-yard line. But that's coming all the way back. Logan Ryan, oh, no, that's on the Broncos. Illegal contact downfield for Tout. The user. Yeah, we haven't heard much from Judy. A lot of speed over there. You would feel like Tout would be finding him. Jerry Judy, just six catches, 56 yards coming in this game. That's a tackle for loss. And Washington with an injury, that's going to stop the clock. That could be big. If a big turnover happens right now, you know Denver still has three timeouts. These injuries before the two-minute warning that just stop the clock and essentially give Denver a timeout. Second and 16, can Lamar climb his way out of this one? Gary Terry going to get man coverage. Last time Tout was on a man, he got a penalty. Got to watch this matchup. To the outside, it's not there. Little slant action. Great defense there by A.J. Boye. He's already got a pick on Lamar. Lamar, one touchdown, three picks. A couple mental mistakes as Sims, one of the leading receivers here on Washington. Him and Scary Terry kind of been a little two-step, a little tandem in D.C. Third and 13, biggest third down of the game. Looking, middle of the field, he's gonna get set. No, he's doing what he does. That's exactly what Lamar Jackson is there to do, make plays like that, man. It's over like a rover. You can't catch what you can't see. And this guy is just too quick. Too fast. Too furious. He's going to get another. He's going to get a touchdown here. Whip it to the left side. That's Geis. The G.U. Ice. He's too nice. Into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington.
Put those sixes up. Because that's a touchdown, baby.
Two 19 left. 19 seconds from the 2 minute warning. This game is over like Rover. We are going to talk to Bananas. A little live call in the air. We're going to ask him about the struggles of Lamar Jackson here coming up. And maybe a little Salt Lake City Q&A. If you guys got any Salt Lake City, Utah Jazz, late 80s, early 90s basketball questions for Brown Chuck, we'll be happy to pass it along. Set.
Incomplete. It's now 2nd and 10 at the 25-yard line.
If only he had Drew Lock. Maybe. Likely not. But maybe not as bad, but a lot of those throws over the middle are just... It's just he just does not have any depth perception. He doesn't have any understanding of... It's a gain of if the guy has a jersey that isn't yours, he's not on your team. And sometimes that is a tough concept for quarterbacks in the NBL to figure out. We're not all playing together. We have defenders and offensive players. Right there, he just misses B. And I think that was just an overthrow there by Barber, just off the mark. What's up, Nick Mazesco? We got Nick Mazesco.
Because that's a touchdown, baby.
Hitting the channel earlier, I thought I actually had the touchdown one. Used it last night on bonus coverage. It's when you're doing the dance, Nick, the little head side to side bobble. Thank you for watching Building the Franchise Washington Football Team episode number one. When in doubt, corner route finds his man on the right side, and that's going to be Noah Fant again. We haven't heard from him in quite a while, I believe. He had his first catch early in the game, and he's been quiet since. Yeah, that's only his second reception on the day. I see 87, a lot of these little spot routes. Dangerous throw, and that's going to be picked off. Give me that. Oh, baby. Too easy.
To throw that interception. He's terrible.
We'll play that back, though.
This guy's got to be blind to throw that interception. He's terrible.
And so, GG's, knee-knees. I'm going to get in the Discord, and we're going to be live on the phone with the owner. And the former Salt Lake City superstar, Ground Chuck. He was a baseline cameraman for the Utah Jazz 1987 to 1994. All your Thurl Bailey, Carl Malone, John Stockton, Jeff Malone, Jeff Hornacek, Mark Eaton. Questions in the chat now, please. So I'm going to ask him what life was like in the late 80s, early 90s, partying with those guys. The only cameraman that actually traveled with the team. We are live with the owner of the Washington Football Team, Bananas. First of all, I got a trivia question for you, Bananas. Are you live with us? Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
All right, let me turn him up a bit because his mic's still stuck in the 80s. All right, Jeff Malone, Carl Malone walk into a bar. Mark Eaton says, hey, let's go party next door. What do?
You go join him, baby.
He goes and joins him, the first cameraman. 1987, 1994, Salt Lake City, Utah Jazz. It was a special time for this guy. Now he's in the NBL, rolling through the Denver Broncos in Mile High. You were the first cameraman in the late 80s, early 90s to travel with the team. You actually went on the road, It's a pretty historic event there for a ground shot. But let's get back to NBL football. Lamar Jackson turnovers. What's going on? If you could keep your stream up, please, that'd be nice as well.
It's Todd's stream.
Yeah.
One of those throws I didn't even see. I literally didn't see the... He was using a guy in a purple zone. I legit didn't see the guy.
He was using the guy in what?
In a purple zone. Like, in a purple zone, he was using him, and I didn't see the person. Like, I literally just threw it because I thought my guy was wide open. And next thing I know, he's just jumping up, catching the ball. I didn't see him at all. So that's completely on me.
No, that's on Lamar Jackson. So what do we have to do to clean it up? A little dead leg by Lamar breaking out for a big touchdown on the ground. That kind of, I feel like that was kind of the end of the game when Lamar Jackson got free. So we are seeing these just flashes of greatness, his ability to get outside the pocket, improvise. But how concerned are you maybe that the in-the-pocket Lamar Jackson, if a team can contain him or at least disrupt his ability to get outside the pocket, you might be in a little bit of trouble here, especially with your lack of talent at the wide receiver position.
It's a new playbook for Lamar. Once we get rolling week 5, week 6, he'll settle in. He'll know what he's supposed to be doing on every play. He's just late on his progressions. Let's give him a little bit of time. He'll fit right in, and he'll be the leader that we need.
How many wins are you getting this year, sitting at 3-0? Broncos fell to 0-3. And they gifted Landon Collins a lot. I think player of the game today, you got Montez Sweat, Landon Collins. Lamar Jackson made some nice plays, but the turnovers, I can't give it to him. Guys played well. But I think Landon Collins really just seemed to be everywhere, all over the field. I think he was on the field, off the field, around the world, upstairs, downstairs, all around the townstairs, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, he catches 2 interceptions. I think he took 2 of them for touchdowns. I believe he has 2 touchdowns on the day. I mean, you can't take that away from him. He was hawking the ball for the entire game.
Yeah, I think Dan Barber in his post-game interview was really, it was really taken aback by y'all, the defensive with Washington, the ability to press up and yet find ways to have these one-on-one coverages, but yet have some type of help. It's like Landon Collins would just kind of break down 5 yards from the line of scrimmage. He thinks he's blitzing. He ends up staying home, and he throws it right to him. Every interception that he had, at least I believe the first 4, were right in between the hashes. It just seemed like he really struggled identifying who's the blitzer and who's dropping coverage.
Yeah, I mean, he's a young quarterback in the league. The Broncos traded in their young quarterback who you thought had all the tools in Drew Lock to a division opponent. And I mean, that's what happens. You put a rookie in there and he's going to make those mistakes, especially early on in the season.
All right, a lot of people asking. I'm going to get your opinion on this. Dan Barber, should he get cut? You see what I did there?
He's
definitely struggling. No Drew Lock, definitely a new system for that team as well. So Denver's going to be 0-3, Washington 3-0. And who do we got coming up next here in Washington? What's the upcoming schedule look like in a very tough division? Won by the Dallas Cowboys last season. Giants are still in rebuilding mode. It looks like it's going to be Washington, Dallas kind of fighting for that final, for that NFC East, at least early on that spot. But upcoming, we got the Oakland Raiders. They're 1-2. That should be a dub. Saints 0-2. That should be a dub. Kansas City Chiefs. That's going to be our next game. I want to get that game here on Building the Franchise. Chiefs, Week 6, Washington. That should be a good one. So what's your prediction on how many games you get this season?
I'm thinking we finish about 11-5. Okay. We win our division. We go to the NFC Championship and take on the Seahawks, potentially maybe the Cardinals. But I'm going to go with the Seahawks.
Nice.
And we defeat the Seahawks. Lamar Jackson's comfortable in his new system. He fits in. He gets the result against the Seahawks. And we go win a Super Bowl.
All right, who'd you say came out of the AFC?
Out of the AFC, I believe it's going to be we're going to have a Cleveland Buffalo
rematch?
AFC Championship rematch. Yep.
And who takes that one?
I think Cleveland takes it this time, and we have Washington Cleveland in the Super Bowl.
Yeah, you ask Bananas how many games he's going to win this year. He just gives you a whole season how it's going to go. It's almost like he's from the future, but we know he's from the past. 87-94. That's the cameraman for the Salt Lake City, Utah Jazz. And with that note, we're out.